Hello. My desk is a mess, but I have a video I want to do. I have a couple items I made for Sue at Paper Inspiration. She's doing a challenge. And you send in two items, handmade items, that are butterfly themed. So I just wanted to share what I made and what I made them from. Today is November 17th, and she needs them by December 17th. I want to get these in the mail tomorrow in hopes that she gets them by that date. So I had a lot of ideas, and I had to reel myself back and get this stuff to her, but I made this long, tall tag, and it's out of a file folder. There's two of them together, and I sewed around. The top is just I took a circle and laid it on there, and then just trimmed it off. And then this is just a piece of jean material. The butterflies are stamped and then die cut out. I did that out of this set here. It stamps and it has the dies to go with it. And this is, sorry, I'm reorganizing my stamps and dies, and this has not made it to that yet. This is art. Art C? I don't know. Oh, it's Sizzix. Well, it says comparable with, but it's Art C. I'll have to look that up. I'll look that up, and if I can find it and put it in the link. I got this secondhand, so but yeah, it comes with five different stamps. You can probably see it better on this side. And then you stamp them, and then it has the coordinating dies. I love this new way of stamping and die cutting. It's really cool. So that's what I did. I believe some like colored paper. And then I stamped on it to give it some more depth. And then just cut them out and put them on there. And then I laid tulle netting. You probably can't see it on camera, but I laid tulle netting on top of there. And that got stitched in. And then on the back side, I just ripped some note paper. I just tore it so that it would kind of fit in there, and I glued that down before I stitched around. So yeah, that's that. And then this is an embroidered butterfly, and I did that on my embroidery machine. I have a Bernina. I do have a video showing how I do that. Not this particular project, but another project. And then I used this die set from Spellbinders. Let me get rid of that. This one is Spellbinders S5399. And it comes with seven dies. I used this one here to cut it out, and then I used this triangle one because these only make the design, that design, and then these will cut it out. So if you wanted this on a large project and just wanted that as like the focal point, like a journal cover or whatever, and you can orient it this way as well if you wanted. But what I did was, this is on embroidered on duck cloth. It's really thick. And I wasn't sure that this was going to work. It was, you know, a little tricky, but I did it. And what I did was I just took brown cardstock. I glued the duck cloth to the brown cardstock. This was after I embroidered the butterfly. And I let it dry. Then I ran it through this with this die here. And had to poke all these little pieces out. Some of them were stubborn, like my butterfly went down into here. So I couldn't get one of those out, but that's okay. I still love the look. And then I was going to turn this into a pocket or of some sort, but I decided just to send this to Sue as is. That way she can put it on a page however she wants. If she wants it down here in the corner or, you know, up here or whatever. I just wanted to leave it that way she could put it in her journal however she wants it. The challenge is send two items in, handmade items that are butterfly themed. She's making two journals, one to give away and one to keep for herself to treasure. So I feel that that's really sweet. I wanted to do that. So I'm hoping that I've been very busy and I hope I make the deadline. So, but yeah, I hadn't really played with this die set a lot, but I'm really loving it now. Now that I know I can go through fabric, that's amazing in the detail. You probably can't see it on camera, but it's truly amazing. I love it. Let's see. I did cut some other stuff out. Let me do this. I have this. It's not cut out perfect, but these come on a sheet. I forget how many on a sheet. But you get them at like Joann's. But you can do it with any digital download or whatever size you're looking for. But these I got them on clearance at Joann's. They were 50% off and it was on a page and I thought they were very cute. They have like different sayings and I just like making stuff out of them to put in my Etsy orders for people. It's just nice to have a little something made to slip in there or glue to a gift bag or something. But they have quite a few. Oops. Another one in there. They have quite a few sayings and they're really cute. Kind of, it just reminded me of spring. You know? Thank you. They have a thank you, hello, warm wishes, grateful, and I just got a box of them here, and I just wanted to make something out of them. There's days when I'm not sure what I want to do, and it's just nice to sit and just make some stuff and have it on the ready. But what I did was I took, oh, not that one, this one. It was this one. Get me. Where are you? I wanted to keep it out to show you the difference. It's probably going to be the last one. That one there. Okay. Let's see, put that over there. Now, when I wanted to do this die, and then when I put it up to it, I was like, oh, it's not really big enough. So then I thought, well, I will just glue it to cream cardstock or whatever coordinating. I could have used, you know, that color green or whatever, but it kind of blended in. So I just glued it onto the cream cardstock and then cut it out. I cut it with this and then this frame around it. So I made my square bigger than this so that I could cut it out. And I really like how that came out. I mean, that just, it went from this, just a plain piece of paper, and that could be a digital or whatever, to this. And I love that. That could be, you know, a pocket. You could put vellum behind there or, you know, anything. Anything. It could be anything. You can even put, I could even stamp lines on here too. It could be a journaling card, whatever. But yeah. So I really like that. And then this is like my favorite set of flowers. I have a few of them. I decided to stamp on one of them. So I'm thinking I might do a set of these because I have quite a few sets. I don't know if they're by the same maker or not. This one's here. Oh, Stampin' Up, of course. Let's see. Yeah, they do have a set. They have this one here. And then this one here, tulips. I don't know what all my flowers are. I wish they would label them on there. But yeah. So I probably look at my stash and see if I have six about the same size. Then I can do like a set of these to put in my shop. That would be cool. I like that. So anyways, well, I wanted to share that. I'm going to get these ready to send to Sue with some other little goodies and hopes that she gets it in time for her, for the challenge. So, because what I heard was mail was really slow. So, and I haven't sent anything to Australia. I don't know if ever, so I don't really know what, you know, what, how long that would take. So, but yeah, I wanted to share what I was sending to her. By the time you see this video, she will have already gotten this stuff, I hope, and have shown it. But I just wanted to document, you know, what I did and how I did it. That way I have it for my reference as well. I kind of wanted to make a couple of these so I had my own, but I'm just going to send them off. I'm going to send them off. So, and I hope she enjoys them. So don't think this is too tall because it had to be 9 by 6.5. Couldn't be over that. I think I'm okay. Whew, yeah, I'm just in. I am just in. Couldn't be over 9 inches, so it'll stick out the top of somewhere, but yeah, wow. Didn't think of that. But I wanted to fit 3 butterflies on there like they were floating on the tag. So yeah. Okay, well, hope everyone is having a good week so far, and take care. Bye.